Okay, here we go. Focus. Speed. I am speed. I'm a mighty engine, sleek and streamlined. I move as fast as the speed of sound. Fast as the speed of sound? I'm not sure about fast as the speed of sound. I'm fast as the Flying Scotsman sounds good. No, stay focused. Speed. I'm faster than fast, quicker than quick. I am Dylan.
Hey Dylan, you ready?
Oh yeah, Dylan's ready. Let's have all. Southern Pacific Scenic Railroad is a large steam tourist railroad located between Granbury and Fort Worth, Texas. It's a rather quaint place. It's a very friendly railroad for steam locomotives, and it's a very friendly place for tourists and rail fans. There are 6 locomotives that work for the SP Scenic, 3 of which are under their 1472-day boiler inspections, and the other 3 are the ones currently running the line. And those 3 are these 3 GS-class locomotives. Their names are Dylan, Liz, and Edward. Their main job is to pull the Southern Pacific Scenic's famous Texan Daylight. They would also haul freight occasionally. One day, Dylan was just pulling into Fort Worth. He had just finished pulling the Texan Daylight there. He was quite thirsty and in need of oil after a 75-mile-per-hour run from Granbury to Fort Worth. Man, that was quite a run, wasn't it?
It sure was.
Well, we better get you some more oil and water before our return trip.
Okay.
As Dylan was fueling up on more oil and water, Liz arrived. She had just finished pulling the Spirit of Cleburne from Cleburne to Fort Worth.
Good morning, Dee.
Good morning, Liz. Nice day, huh?
It sure is.
Looks like you've been busy hauling the Spirit of Cleburne, hmm?
Yep, I have been. And it's quite the hard work.
I bet.
Hey, did you hear about what's happening tomorrow?
No. No, I haven't.
Tomorrow's your 59th build day.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be 59 years old.
Yes, sir. So, there's going to be an excursion tomorrow at 12 o'clock at noon, and you, me, and Edward are gonna pull it from Granbury to Fort Worth and back.
Alright, I'll be ready.
So will I.
Well, we better get going. We gotta get all these passengers to their destinations. The Texan Daylight doesn't move itself. Roger that. See ya, Liz.
See ya, Dee.
Good morning, Liz. Good morning, Edward.
Good morning, Dylan.
Good morning, Dylan, and happy build day.
Aw, thank you, Liz. Are you guys ready for the big day ahead of us?
We sure are.
Yep. Well then, let's get rolling. We got a lot of work that needs to be done before 12 o'clock.
Alrighty then.
Dylan, Liz, and Edward were working hard. They wanted to get all their jobs done before 12 o'clock and be ready for the excursion when the time comes. Dylan was assigned to pull the Texan Daylight, Liz was assigned to pull the Spirit of Cleburne, and Edward was assigned to pull a freight train. They worked hard. Dylan and Liz took their passengers to their rightful destinations, and Edward took his cargo to its rightful destination. They were all right on time and without delay. Dylan, Liz, and Edward had finished all their work 30 minutes before the excursion would depart. Liz had already shunted the coaches out and everything was ready for the big event.
Welp, looks like we're all done.
Yep, and with only 30 minutes to spare. And everything's ready for the excursion and soon we'll be flying down the tracks to Fort Worth and back.
That's right, Dee.
I've been looking forward to this for quite a while, and I'm pretty excited for it.
So am I.
Same here.
You know, I just can't believe that I'm 59 years old and I'm still running.
Well, Dylan, you've come a long way from where you began. From the first day you arrived on Southern Pacific to the present day.
And I'm glad that I still have you guys along my side. Besides, where would I be without you guys?
That I do not know.
Say, guys, what do you say we go rest our wheels in the roundhouse? We've only got 30 minutes before we have to depart.
I'm down.
Me too.
Later, Dylan, Liz, and Edward were all coupled up to the train, ready for the straight run to Fort Worth.
Well, guys, this is it.
Yep, it sure is.
All aboard!
Well, we better get going.
Today, yeah. Life is a highway.
Alright guys, we're almost to Tarrant. All we have to do is tackle this hill. Roger that.
Will do.
Then there was trouble. As they were climbing over the hill, one of Edward's crank pins snapped.
Ah, crap!
What happened? One of my crank pins have snapped.
Oh dear.
And so they had to stop the train to inspect the damage. Edward's engineer and fireman examined where Edward's crank pin had snapped.
Oh dear. This is bad.
What should we do? Well, we're gonna have to have Dylan and Liz pull the train on their own without Edward's help. Do you two think you can manage pulling the train all on your own?
We'll try. And soon, the train was moving again. Dylan and Liz had to manage the train all on their own without Edward to help them. He had to roll behind them, just like a piece of rolling stock. Are you okay, Edward?
Yeah, I'm alright. I just don't know why my crank pin broke.
Don't worry, Edward. Maybe when we get to the next station, we might get your crank pin fixed.
Besides, I'm sure the damage you got isn't that bad.
What's the problem?
One of Edward's crank pins had snapped. We were climbing up the hill before the station when it happened.
I see.
Do you think we can repair him before we leave for Fort Worth?
Well, unfortunately not. You've only got 10 minutes before departure, and that's not enough time to fix Edward's side rods. You're gonna have to pull him straight to Fort Worth and back.
Dylan, Liz, are you two okay pulling the rest of the train to Fort Worth?
We'll try our best.
Soon, they reached Fort Worth. Many rail fans and tourists gathered around the engines and started taking their pictures of them. Man, this is quite a crowd. Hey guys?
Yep.
It sure is. Rail fans, foamers, and tourists all here to see us. It's quite the sight to behold.
Yep, it sure is. It's very nice to know that there are so many people that love steam locomotives.
Indeed. They really do love seeing steam locomotives still in operation. If it weren't for Franklin and Ike Madison, we wouldn't have made it as far as we did.
That's true, Liz. But if it also weren't for Franklin and Ike, we would have been lost to the scrapper's torch.
Indeed.
A few hours later, the train was turned back around and the three engines were making their way back to Granbury.
Man, those foamers were really eager to get a picture of us. Even a selfie with us, for that matter.
Ah, well, you know, foamers are always excited to see a steam locomotive. Plus, they do it for fun and for the memories.
That is true, Edward. Now, let's get this train home. Later on, the three engines were only a few miles away from Granbury. They were passing through the Godley Junction when...
Oh no! Please don't tell me your crank pins had snapped too, Liz.
Yes, they have.
Dang it! First me, now Liz. And soon, they had to stop the train again.
Well, what should we do now? Well, I guess we could just phone in a bus for the passengers.
No.
What? Why?
Let me take them home.
You want to pull the train the rest of the way there all by yourself?
Yes, I do. It's either I get there or burst. With one mighty heave, Dylan's wheels dug into the rails, and the train started moving again. It was slow to get going, but it got easier to pull as it sped up.
Well done, Dylan. Keep on going.
Triumph, Dylan brought the train home.
After the passengers had gotten off, Ike Madison, the Southern Pacific Scenic Railroad's controller, stepped up to the platform to see the engines.
Dylan, I am quite impressed with what you did. You did well getting that train the rest of the way here all on your own.
Oh, it was really nothing, sir.
He took it like a champ.
Indeed he did.
Well done, Dylan. You truly are a very capable locomotive to this railroad. As a reward, you will get to pull the Texan Daylight and no freight trains for 3 weeks.
Aw, thank you, sir.
My pleasure. Now, Dylan, can you take Liz and Edward to the locomotive shop, please?
Yes, sir.
Soon, Liz and Edward were repaired. They had their crank pins fixed, and they were ready to get back to work.
So guys, you ready to get rolling again?
We sure are.
Hopefully this time we won't snap our crank pins.
So, what do you say we highball?
Let's do it.